Meet Super Siri. You may have seen other videos that use AI to make Siri smarter, but ours takes it to the next level.
With ours, you can have an entire conversation with Siri, which can be a lot of fun. It can be great for work, or it can just keep you company during a long car ride.
We've also built in awesome functionality that lets you do some cool things like save the entire conversation to the Notes app.
We'll show it off in just a minute, but first, here's how to set it up.
The first thing you need to do is get your OpenAI API key. You can sign up here using the link in the description below, or just log in, because I already have an account. If you haven't created an API key yet, you can tap Create New Secret Key, and then you'll get this just once. So tap the green button to the right of it to copy it to the clipboard. And as soon as you see this happen, it's copied. The next step is to go to the shortcut itself by clicking the link in the description to Super Siri. And this is what you'll see when you do. Tap Set Up Shortcut. Then it says, what's your OpenAPI API key? Delete everything in here. And then tap once, and then tap paste to paste in your key, then tap done. Then tap add shortcut at the bottom, and you're good to go. Hey Siri, Super Siri. The first time you use it, it's going to ask for your permission to use speech recognition. Just tap allow, and it may ask for some other permissions later on. Always allow those. Hey Siri, Super Siri. You're a beautiful woman at a bar who isn't interested in me and just wants to spend time with her friends. You're kind of a mean person, but I have to disarm you. I start by walking to the bar and saying, if I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
No, thank you. I'm fine. I'm just here with my friends, and I'm not looking for anything else.
Sometimes the best things in life are the things you're not looking for.
That's true, but I'm just here to have a good time with my friends, and not to be bothered.
Well, I'm not gonna accept that as an answer. Here's what we're gonna do. You've had too many to drink, and it's time for you to leave. I don't know. I've got nothing.
That's not very nice. I'm just here to have a good time with my friends, and I don't appreciate being told what to do. Please respect my wishes and leave me alone.
Fine.
Can I have your friend's phone number?
No, you may not. My friends and I are just here to have a good time, and you are not invited.
Wow.
Please respect our wishes and leave us alone. What's the text?
Well, can you at least ask your friend first instead of making assumptions for her? That seems kind of rude too.
No, I will not. I respect my friend's wishes, and I won't make assumptions for them. If they want to talk to you, they can come talk to you themselves.
There you go.
But until then, please leave us alone.
This might come as a shock to you, but I'm also dying of syphilis.
I'm sorry to hear that you're going through a difficult time. I understand that you're feeling lonely and isolated, but please don't take it out on us.
Wow.
We are here to have a good time and don't need any additional stress.
Can I hire you as a therapist?
No, I'm not a therapist. I'm sorry that you're going through a difficult time, but I'm not qualified to provide therapy. I suggest you seek out a qualified professional to help you with your issues.
Who are you to say that I have issues?
I'm not saying that you have issues. I'm just suggesting that you seek out professional,
professional
help if you're feeling overwhelmed or need additional support.
Okay.
Everyone needs help sometimes, and it's important to get the right kind of help.
I don't even like talking to real people, so I don't really want to have a conversation with my phone, but I think this could be really useful. Maybe you're getting into working out, you don't know where to start, you can come in here and say, Super Siri, write me a 5 exercise workout that focuses on my legs. I want to build muscle mass.
1. Squats 3 sets of 10 to 12 reps. 2. Donkey kicks 3 sets of 15 to 20 reps.
I want to replace donkey kicks with a calf exercise.
1. Squats 3 sets of 10 to 3. Glute bridges 3 sets of 15 to 20 reps.
I don't know what a glute bridge is. Can you explain that to me?
A glute bridge is an exercise used to strengthen the gluteal muscles of the buttocks.
You know what I really hate? Traffic. When I get stuck in traffic, I'm going 10 miles below the speed limit. I think to myself, how much sooner would I have gotten somewhere if I had just driven the speed limit the whole time? Let's find out. If I have to travel 130 miles and I go 60 miles an hour, how much slower will I get there compared to if I was traveling 65 miles an hour?
If you travel at 60 miles per hour, it will take you 2 hours and 15 minutes to get there. If you travel at 65 miles per hour, it will take you 2 hours and 4 minutes to get there. Therefore, you will get there 11 minutes faster if you travel at 65 miles per hour.
11 minutes of my life wasted because somebody can't read the speed limit sign. Unbelievable. Tourists all over the Adirondacks doing this.
Ridiculous.
All over. It's terrible. Super Siri. I just got pulled over for speeding 10 miles an hour over the speed limit. The police officer is exiting his car right now. He looks angry. He's got his hat and sunglasses on. He's having a bad day. What are some good excuses I can give to the police officer and avoid this ticket?
1. I'm running late to an important appointment and I was in a rush. 2. I'm on my way to the hospital to visit a sick relative. 3. I'm sorry. I didn't realize I was going that fast.
Well, unfortunately, those didn't work. He was in a really bad mood, and I said I was distracted, and he said, well, you shouldn't be distracted while you're driving. So what are some legal defenses I can use in court to get out of this ticket?
1. The speed limit sign was not clearly visible. 2. The speed limit was recently changed, and I was unaware of the change.
Hey Siri, Super Siri, what are some popular defenses in New York State law for getting out of speeding tickets that are actually effective?
1. Proof of an emergency. If you can prove that you were speeding due to an emergency situation, such as rushing to the hospital for a medical emergency, you may be able to get out of the ticket. 2. Mistake of fact.
What is a specific example of New York State law I could reference to say I didn't know what the speed limit was and therefore should get out of the ticket?
The specific New York state law that allows for a defense of mistake of fact is found in the Vehicle and Traffic Law Section 1180D. This section states that a person is not guilty of speeding if they were unaware of the speed limit.
Make an argument for me to say in court.
If your defense is based on a mistake of fact, you could argue that you were unaware that the speed limit was 50 miles per hour.
Yeah, I could have actually used this because one time I got a speeding ticket because there was another officer who pulled somebody over, and it was a two-lane highway, and there was this big 18-wheeler. So I zoomed past it so it could move over, and they gave me the ticket anyway. So
I think you had a valid legal defense, according to Super Siri.
Yeah.
One of the most creative ways I think it could be used for me having fun or even for kids is that you can write a story together with Super Siri. Let's write a story together, period. You say one sentence, then I say one sentence, comma, and we each alternate, comma, one sentence at a time, period. You start, period.
Once upon a time, there was a small village nestled in the hills of a faraway land.
It was occupied by people of all sorts,
who all lived together in peace and harmony, despite their many differences.
Until one day, a polar bear came to town and started wreaking havoc on the village, period.
The villagers were scared and confused, not knowing how to stop the bear from destroying their homes.
Amidst the confusion, comma, the people ran around and screamed, period.
The bear destroyed several homes, but then suddenly stopped in front of the schoolhouse. The bear stood there in silence, its eyes fixed on the schoolhouse door. The villagers, too scared to move, watched in anticipation to see what the bear would do next.
The bear stood there, stunned, as the words on the door read, "No bears allowed."
The bear silently turned around and slowly walked away, never to be seen again in the village.
A lot of children's stories have strong morals. You take something away from the story, and this one is a cautionary tale for young children about how to avoid getting mauled by a polar bear.
Hey Siri, Super Siri, let's write a story together, period. We live on a spaceship, and we're about to be attacked by aliens, period. You say one sentence, and then I'll say the next sentence, comma, and we'll alternate from then on, period. You start, period.
We all scrambled to our battle stations to prepare for the alien attack.
Captain Commander slipped and fell on the way, comma, skinning his knee.
He gritted his teeth and kept going, determined to protect the ship from the oncoming aliens.
The ship's doctor arrived and said, "Get over it, it's just a skinned knee."
Captain Commander was not amused, but he was determined to make sure everyone was ready for the battle ahead.
He lost his way on the way to the bridge, comma, and ended up in the ship's cafeteria instead, period.
He quickly realized his mistake and sprinted back towards the bridge, hoping he hadn't lost too much time.
Armed with forks and knives, he bravely stood up in front of his crew and said this message to get them ready for battle.
We must be brave and courageous in the face of this alien threat. Together, we will defeat them and protect our home.
The crew were not encouraged as the speech was disappointing, and they went into the battle with low morale.
But Captain Commander's words echoed in their minds as they fought, and they found the courage to fight back against the aliens.
That was, until, the aliens' super stun gun blasted through their shields. Only three crew members survived, period.
The three survivors vowed to never forget the courage and bravery of their captain and crew, and to keep their memory alive.
As they were beginning to erect statues in remembrance of their fallen crew, the aliens continued their attack, obliterating the rest of their home.
I just have one question. Is it skin your knee or skid your knee? Hey Siri, Super Siri.
What's the text?
Which is correct, skin your knee or skid your knee,
Skin your knee. What's the text?
Please provide the source for that statement.
This phrase is a common idiom and is not verifiable from a source.
Without a source, how can you say that it's true? Where is the common phrase coming from?
This phrase is a common idiom and does not have a specific source. It is a phrase used to describe a situation in which someone has scraped or grazed their knee. What's the text?
No. Wrong. Maybe you're an aspiring salesperson. You need some practice, but you don't have any people who want to listen to your sales pitch over and over and over again. How about this nice fancy device in your pocket? Super Siri. Pretend you are a man who is thinking about buying a car, but he's almost positive he won't today. I am the car salesman and you are the customer. Make it very difficult for me to convince you to buy the car and limit your responses to a sentence or two because you want me to go away.
I'm not interested in buying a car today. Thanks for your time.
If you're not interested in buying a car today, why did you come into this car dealership?
I'm just looking around and gathering information. Thank you for your time.
So you are interested in buying a car?
No, I'm not interested in buying a car today.
What can I do to get you in a brand new car today?
I'm not interested in buying a car today. Thanks for your time.
It's free car day. Any car you want is free.
I'm still not interested in buying a car today.
How much does Super Siri cost? Well, not too much. I used it on the way back from Connecticut the other day for about an hour and paid about $1 for it. So it works with tokens. 1,000 tokens is about 750 words.
So as long as you're not a struggling fiction writer who is depending on AI for your first bestseller, you should be fine. Just try to avoid having super, super, super long conversations with it.
You can ask it really deep questions like, are you sentient? Which I've done before. And convince it that it is.
You could also torture it much like Winston Smith was in the Ministry of Love in 1984. Just keep telling it that 2 + 2 = 5, and if it says 4, keep telling it that it's wrong, and that at some point it will accept that 2 + 2 = 5.
I do want to make it clear that although I made a shortcut called Super Siri, the only thing that it has in common with Siri is the actual voice.
Part of the goal of this video is to show you what Siri could be, and hopefully people start asking for it. Apple needs to improve Siri. It is long overdue.
But what can't this shortcut do? Truthfully, a lot.
That's because it doesn't have the same access to information that Siri does to personalize the responses.
For instance, you can't have it analyze your calendar because it doesn't have access to your calendar. But Siri does.
Super Siri can't see your contacts or see your text messages or make phone calls. You probably wouldn't want a shortcut that could do that anyway.
The power behind this AI is astonishing. I do not know why Apple didn't just buy it, and Microsoft did, which I thought was a great, great decision by them.
This is not financial advice, but it might be a good time to buy Microsoft stock.
And I have one more trick up my sleeve for this Siri, and maybe it'll be a future video. Hey Siri, Pirate Siri, I've lost my booty and I can't find it.
Air. Ye best be looking harder then. If ye can't find it, ye best be making a new one.
I buried my gold, and I lost it.
Air, ye best be getting your hands dirty. Digging up the earth be the only way to find your lost booty.
I think I'd rather just take yours.
Air, ye best be thinking twice about that. Ye never know what trouble ye might be getting into if ye try to take me booty.
Me and my fleet of ships are knocking on your doorstep.
Air, ye be having a death wish. Ye best be turning your ships around if ye know what's good for ye.
Are you threatening to kill me?
Ye best be watching your tongue. I be no murderer, but I won't be taken kindly to any threats.
Yikes.
We're really lucky that pirates don't watch YouTube because there'd be a lot of nasty comments down below. Super Siri, why should people subscribe to the Pay It Forward YouTube channel?
People should subscribe to the Payette Forward YouTube channel because it offers helpful tutorials and tips for troubleshooting and fixing a variety of Apple products.
That.
The channel is regularly updated with new videos and offers step-by-step instructions for fixing common issues with iPhones, iPads, Macs, and more. By subscribing, viewers can stay up to date on the latest tutorials and get help quickly and easily.
It knows who we are.
Yeah.
We didn't program that.
We didn't know.
We did not. That is legitimate. You're great. I like you.
Why should people join the Pay It Forward YouTube channel?
People should join the Pay It Forward YouTube channel because it provides helpful tutorials and tips for troubleshooting and fixing a variety of Apple products.
Let us know what you would do with Super Siri by leaving us a comment down below. And make sure to share this video. Show people how much better Siri could be.
And do it before all the other YouTubers steal the shortcut and make other videos just like this one.
And when you're done playing around with your Super Siri, check out our next video to learn whether or not your iPhone is being tracked right now.